Hi. In our today's video, we're going to be talking about the fuel pump relay. So you see, the fuel pump relay is a device that primarily runs the fuel pump. Every version of W124, 126 or other models from the Ke-Jetronic era had these. Well, not in the beginning. In the beginning they were a bit smaller and they have been doing the thing that was primarily predicted for them to do. To run the fuel pump. So, a fuel pump relay drives a fuel pump. Logical. They had six contacts. The later versions, as they have been developed, those versions had some more contacts and some more features. This is out of my car. I have a W124. In W126, the only difference was that only contacts 1 and 3 were blank, and the others had the function. So they had 10 contacts out of 12. Well, what is common for all W124 and 190 versions is that contacts number 1, 3 and 5 are blank. The ones that have automatic transmission, they had number 6 here. Well, let's see what it says. So we go from right to left. This is number 1, blank. Number 2, you cannot see here, it says TF. Then number 3, blank. Number 4 says 87V, then number 5 nothing again, number 6 was 87K, and then we have number 7, 87, then we have number 8, 30, we have number 9, that was 15, that is 15. Number 10 is TD. Number 11, 31. And number 12 is 50. What do these numbers mean, and these letters and numbers? Well, let's start from the end. From number 12, it was 50. Number 50, it was the starter contact. Then number 11, it's 31. That's the ground. Then number 10 is TD, that's the RPM signal. Then number 9 was 15, that's the ignition key, ignition on. And then we have number 30, that was the positive. plus or positive coming from the battery. Then we have number 7, it was 87. This was for the fuel pump. This was the positive to the fuel pump. And not just that, it was also on a W124 and 190 models, also the contact for the lambda, for the heater, as well as the choke, let's say it, that was well, you know, when you start the car and the additional air is being sucked, so the suction for the additional air, it's there. Number 6, it says 87K. K stands for kickdown. Well, as I drive manual, then I don't have this contact. Number 1 and 3, nothing. Number 4 was 97V. That was for a cold start valve. Number 2 was the TF. It's from German Temperaturfühler. It's the coolant temperature sensor. So, now, what are the symptoms of a bad fuel pump relay? Well, it's simple. You cannot start your car because, you know, your fuel pump is dead. If this thing is dead, then your fuel pump is dead, your cold start valve is dead, your coolant temperature sensor is dead, and that's pretty much it. So how can you know if you want to crank to start the car and you do not succeed? Is it a fuel pump? The fuel pump or the fuel pump relay? Well, there are some values and some methods how to check this. For example, you measure, let me just see, contacts number 8 and number 11. Number 8 is a plus and number 11 is the ground. And you must get approximately 12 volts. But I want to do this my way, and better do it my way, to see whether your fuel pump is bad or your fuel pump relay is bad. How can we do that? You remember what this is? With this simple thing. This is the best possible way to check if your fuel pump relay is bad or not. So with the relay in, you try to crank the car. If the car starts, okay, then it's everything okay. If it doesn't, if it comes to fuel pump relay to be checked, then take it out, pull it out of the engine, and with this wire, one like this, you can put this in, you can bridge the contacts 7 and 8. on the Relay 87 and 30. That way you're going to start to activate the fuel pump. Then you turn the ignition on before, then you put the wire in the contact 7 and 8, and if the fuel pump starts working, well, your fuel pump relay then is bad. And that's the best way for the relay to check if it is working or it is kaput, as Germans would say it. As for W126 versions, I forgot to say, they have here one more contact. It is contact number 5, and it is labeled as 87H. H stands for German Heizung, heating. So that's the contact where the lambda is being activated. The heating element for lambda, that's what I wanted to say. And of course, W126 has this contact number 6. That's for that's the option for kickdown. And that's it. You see, for example, here we have contact number 10. It is TD, it's the RPM signal. So the RPM signal operates the fuel pump relay. And then it needs also a positive supply, that's number 30, then the negative 31, and so on. So if this thing is shut, then you can start your car. You can bridge these two contacts with the wire like this, and you can start the car. But this relay operates the CTS, the coolant temperature sensor. And depending on the temperature of the coolant, then the coolant, the sensor is going to send a signal to the fuel pump relay to know, for it to know if it should activate the cold start valve or not. The cold start valve is being activated up to 60 degrees C. Afterwards, it's not non-operational anymore. And but let it be some other story for some other video. Here we have the Mercedes-Benz number, how many cylinders, and this is the limitation, the limiter. Let's say if you go over 6200 RPM, then the relay should turn off, should cut the RPM. So my dear ones, if you enjoyed this video, then please don't click the button skip ad. It is going to help me a lot. And till the next video, happy Mercedesing. Bye.